You made it to Thursday, Del Marva. Hope you've had a fantastic week. Thanks for joining us today on Coast Life. We're your hosts. I'm Paige Marley.
I'm Leah Rizzo, and we've had some frosty starts to the morning.
Yep.
I think this weekend is supposed to kind of pop up in temperature, although
yes.
Usually with that this time of year comes some rain.
Definitely, but I think Saturday should be nice. I'm really looking forward to it. I think I just need to open up my windows and get the spring cleaning feel done.
Is that not
done.
The best feeling in the world? The first time you crack the windows open after the cold winter, and you can just feel a slight warmth and that fresh air. And you're like, this is life.
Unless your dog's name is Ziggy Marley, like me, and he jumps out of screens, window screens, to get the dogs outside.
What you doing?
We just fixed our screen door, and we were so excited. And then the first nice day, a few weeks ago, we're like, let's open it. Busted right out.
Ziggy.
Yeah.
How you doing, buddy?
Yeah. And don't forget, this is a townhouse, so we're pretty high up, and it's the most terrifying thing. But anyways.
Oh, man.
Hopefully your dog doesn't do that.
Hopefully not. But a lot of us are preparing for Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Feeling romantic. Mm-hmm. But Tinder is actually doing something fun. If you have one of those nasty ex tattoos that you got written on you back in the day.
We're not going to judge you.
No
this
judgment.
This is not a judgment zone. Or this is a judgment-free zone. Not all the time. But it is right now, because I could only imagine, it sounds kind of funny, you have your ex's name tattooed, and we could laugh about it, but that has to be a little traumatizing.
I think it can be, for sure, in a lot of ways. I mean, depending on the reason why or how you came to the conclusion of getting your person's name tattooed on you, permanently there, boom, whatever. Whether it's a nice gesture at the time, and sometimes you grow as people, and sometimes you grow apart as people.
Yeah.
And what Tinder is doing is a promotion called Ink Twice.
Cute.
Ink Twice.
Yeah, that's cute.
And at a couple specific tattoo parlors in New York, LA, and Miami, and Austin.
Oh, fun.
So you got a couple places that you can choose from.
Yeah.
And to sort of activate the promotion, I think you can swipe within the app. There's a notification that you can swipe on to get more information. But
I love this.
Yeah.
Very cool.
There's so many talented tattoo artists out there that they can do something really creative. And I think in a way, it kind of helps you reclaim that space on your own body to have, something bad turn into something really beautiful and nice that you want.
Exactly. Now, I feel for you if you have any tattoo that you're regretting, but especially a name of someone, especially if they just stink, And I know two lovely ladies who got tattoos of men that they weren't even dating, and these men were like, you should get my name tattooed, prove that you love me, and then we'll date. You're so trash if you do that.
That's,
or woman.
Manipulative.
It's
manipulative. A manipulative tactic from either person.
Yeah, and I hope that these lovely ladies can get these covered up because, especially if your name is something that stinks.
Ugh.
I'm not going to say any names. I don't want to.
We're not going to judge that hard. Remember, judgment-free zone.
It was a judgment-free zone a minute ago, unless you ask someone to get your name tattooed on you and then leave them and become
then
trash.
It's not. Right. Then we judge you.
Hopefully this isn't controversial. I'm hoping you guys are like, yeah, we agree.
I think so.
Hopefully. Okay. Well, let's talk some good Valentine stuff. Okay?
Yes.
So, men. We want to talk about this because Valentine's Day tends to be for the women.
Yes.
And I get why. We tend to be a little more romantic and sensitive about these things, and that's all good. We want to celebrate the men. So we asked on our social medias, men, what do you want for Valentine's Day? And I was pleasantly surprised with how many people we spoke with that said very sentimental things.
Yeah, exactly. I know I had one response that just said, happy wife and a little rose emoji. And I was like, oh, that's
cute. I love
that. We've also gotten a lot of cute movie date nights and just simple things that kind of, It's that quality time that you're spending together that I think really both people in a relationship tend to want.
Definitely. Because men gifts, for some reason, they kind of tend to be a little more expensive. Unless you're doing clothes or something. But we were talking if our hobbies for our guys would be guns and trucks and cars. As for our hobbies are reading.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of a cheaper hobby. But I think that it's sweet that these men want quality time and there isn't a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
And I think if he is putting a lot of pressure, he should relax. I was telling you, I saw this TikTok of a girl. She made lunch for her husband ahead of Valentine's Day, and she made everything heart-shaped. His sandwich is hearts.
Cute.
His dessert was hearts. And some of the girls in the comments were like, my man would not appreciate this. He'd think it was dumb.
Oh, no.
Get a new man.
Yeah.
That's not okay.
Your man shouldn't think any gesture that you do for him is dumb. And if he tells you that, that's awful.
It is.
That's not the kind of thing that you...
No. And I think the equivalent is the girls who are like, he better get me a diamond necklace for Valentine's Day.
Yeah, right.
Relax.
Also, no. Chill. Yeah, we all know budgets are tight these days.
Exactly. Like. That's why I like talking to our coworkers. Some of the guys were like, I would love a box of chocolates.
Yeah.
Who doesn't like chocolate?
I know.
So take the
food.
Edge off. Right. Take the edge. Unless that's your thing. Maybe Valentine's Day is a big thing. You spend lots of money. Go for it.
Yes.
But the pressure's off, ladies.
But yeah, know that about your man. Know that about your person. Just know that, like, when you're giving romantic gifts, know what they like. And I mean, I know that my man's hobbies are so out of my wheelhouse that I'm like, even if I was going to drop a lot of money on something, I'm like, I might drop a lot of money on the wrong thing.
No one wants me going to pick out gun parts.
No.
That would be very dangerous.
No, not for us.
We're going to stick with the box of chocolates, quality time.
Yes.
Valentine's Day, I think, for us this year.
One more thing to kind of talk about before we dive into the show today. Self-cleaning bathroom. We all know that we hate cleaning the bathroom. So what would you give? Is there something in the world that you would give up in order to have a bathroom that cleans itself?
I would not. I would not give up anything. Maybe I'd give up something I don't care about, which defeats the purpose. When you first hear this, and maybe a lot of moms would give something up.
Probably.
But I'm kind of like, I've made it this far, cleaning the bathroom. It's fine. What about you?
Yeah, I mean, as it stands, our bathroom is small.
Okay.
So it's really not that much square footage to clean. I mean, still the shower, the tub, like everything in there is old, so it's hard to clean. But we kind of split the bathroom cleaning anyway. Like I do sort of the generic sweep, and then he gets in there and really like cleans the bathroom.
I love that.
I'm like, nice.
That's really good. Yeah, that could be a great gift for maybe, especially if you have a busy mom in your life.
Yes.
Clean her bathroom for Valentine's Day.
Yes.
She would love that. I was telling you earlier, the only gift I want for Valentine's Day is for the beard hairs to not be left in the sink.
Yeah. Honey. Yeah, I mean, everybody has their list of complaints that their partner has that I know, like, for a lot of guys, it's the makeup stains that may or may not be all over the sink or the mirror. I know, for me, the little, like, toothpaste flicks on the mirror.
How do they even get there? I think I'm like...
Some of them are for me too, but I'm like, how? Why? Yeah. How did this happen?
Yeah.
I know that our hair in the drain is also the biggest. I mean, if you've ever had to snake the drain, it's the worst. And everybody's always like on the verge of gagging when you pull out this like 8-foot clump of like fur ball and you're like...
Yeah, literally, I would not give up anything to not clean the bathroom again, but I would give up a lot to not have the beard hairs. But it isn't a fair exchange. I know he's tired of my hair in the shower. So that's what we'll get for each other for Valentine's Day is just a cleaner bathroom.
Honestly,
simple things.
It's a great gift.
Yeah, it is.
We're here for you.
Always.
But we're also always here to show off our wonderful Coastal Delmarva community. That is what we're going to be doing on the show today. Coming up today on Coast Life, we know that Milford has been booming. If you are looking to make Milford your happy place, we've got the perfect real estate agents to talk with.
And just yesterday, we showed you some sweet game day grub. Today, Leah's going to show us an even more savory, delicious one.
And it's Thursday. That means we are spilling some gossip. We are spilling the tea with our Spill the Tea segment. All that and more is headed your way today on Coast Life.
Coast Life is sponsored by BB Healthcare, Coastal Comfort Heating and Air Conditioning, Preston Automotive Group, Shell Brothers, and the Parker Group.
The road is always open. Run to Vernon Powell for the top running brands like Hoka, Brooks, and New Balance, plus expert advice and that Vernon Powell fit. Vernon Powell in Salisbury and Rehoboth Beach.
Bright yellow dandelions, a clear signal that the time for prevention is now, for crabgrass and clover are soon to follow. Hillside Lawn Service has been making lawns around the Chesapeake healthier and weed-free for over 30 years. They don't mow it, they grow it. Hillside certified agronomists test your soil, apply exactly what it needs, and nothing it doesn't. Their high-efficiency formulas help protect our waterways. Switch to Hillside now and get $25 off their annual maintenance program. Call Hillside Lawn Service for your free assessment.
Thank you for calling Coastal Comfort.
This is a complimentary call. A couple of years ago, I had my heat pumps replaced. Last night, I noticed one of them wasn't working right. Somebody was out here within a couple of hours, and it's working perfectly. But I was in the service industry for 33 years. Good service is something you can't find today. It very much is appreciated. Your crew is a good crew. Really fine people are professional, and they're efficient.
Coastal Comfort, a Carrier factory authorized dealer. Carrier, turn to the experts.
Here for this nonsense? Let's just stop and rest. Oh wait, look, there's Hank.
Hey, Hank.
I wish I had a Hank like that. Girl, I wish I had a house like that.
I heard he has a screened-in back porch.
Nah, I heard he has a courtyard.
You know he has a dog washing station in his house?
We should definitely invite ourselves over.
Right? We do need a spa day.
Yes, spa day.
Yeah, I say mani-pedi. Look at my nails. I've been digging in flower beds all day.
Enjoy an evening of elegance and unmask a child's future at the 10th Annual Boys and Girls Club Masquerade Ball. Dress up and bring your finest mask to the Lighthouse Cove Events Center in Dewey Beach on Saturday, February 24th. Doors open at 6 for live and silent auctions, an open bar, dinner, and dancing. Save the date and help fund scholarships and key initiatives that benefit kids in our community. For more information, call 302-841-9639.
It's Vernon Powell's Winter Clearance. Save up to 50% off shoes and boots, up to half off apparel and handbags. Winter Clearance markdowns throughout the store on over 200 brands. Don't miss the Winter Clearance event at Vernon Powell, happening now in Salisbury and Rehoboth Beach.
You're watching Coast Life, and we've introduced you to the Parker Group with Rachel and Dustin Parker in studio. But did you know that they serve areas of Kent and Sussex County? So we're going to take a tour of the buildings from the Parker Group. We're starting in Georgetown, so let's take a look inside. We're inside the Georgetown building for the Parker Group, and it's a beautiful building. I'm here with Hannah. Tell me a little bit about this building, because all things considered, it's fairly new, but you guys have done a great job with this.
Yeah, so we've built it in 2019, so it's about 4 years old now. It's kind of our headquarters for the company, and a lot of our agents spend a lot of time here working in our various office locations, and our staff is actually located here as well, so this is kind of our corporate headquarters.
Yeah, and it's cool because it's such a great vibe when you walk in. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's very welcoming, the staff is always very friendly, and there's a lot of celebration of the community as well, as you can kind of see on the mural behind us.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about the artwork here.
Yeah, so we actually have three murals in our office, and they all kind of represent the areas we serve. So all of Delaware and a little bit into Maryland's Eastern Shore. So we have the actual state of Delaware and bridges, and then we've got a lot of farmland references, beach references, so you'll see that throughout.
Well, there's a little bit more to the Georgetown office, so we're going to head upstairs in just a second. One of the things that I think a lot of people, when they come to the office, will see a lot of the greenery, mm-hmm. and of course, a lot of messaging. I mean, the happy place. We know we've talked to Rachel and Dustin about it in studio before and the Coast Life couch, but it really is something that you guys hold near and dear to your mm-hmm. hearts with the Parker Group. And tell me a little bit about your sort of core values, your mission.
Yeah, so like she said, our mission statement is to help people find their happy place, whether that be in a career or in their new home or even in a new state. We really pride ourselves on making it a really comfortable and enjoyable experience rather than just a purchase of a home or a sale of a home. And in doing so, we kind of focus on local. We really enforce local, and we try to use local businesses and local vendors. And then in doing so, we also have a really technology-based approach, and we utilize the highest technology that we possibly can throughout the process.
Awesome. Well, Hannah, this has been great. And the Georgetown office isn't the only place we have to get to. We're taking a trip to Milford next. We're here with Megan now, and one thing that I've noticed about each of these offices is they're all really unique and they're all really interesting, mm-hmm. whether it's brand new or we're taking a more historical approach, and that's kind of what we have here in the Milford office. Tell me a little bit about the building.
Yeah, so this is one of the Milford like historic landmark buildings. So when we moved into this office, which just opened this year, we really were trying to keep some of that historic character while modernizing the space. Mm-hmm. So we do have, similar to the Georgetown office, we have that mural, and then we have the original ceiling that got painted, but we did put in, you know, new floors, new office spaces, stuff like that.
Yeah, and sort of being in downtown Milford, I mean, this is sort of the heart of the Milford community. You guys are surrounded by amazing businesses. You're also, you partake in several local events too. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, we're here all the time. So for things like Third Thursday, Riverfest, St. Patrick's Day, we had a big event. And then the upcoming Halloween parade will be here October 18th. We have a float in the parade, and the office will be open as well.
Yeah, there's a heartbeat in Milford for mm-hmm. sure. Well, we still have one more location to check out, so we're going to be headed to Lewis on the way. As you can see, the Parker Group has locations all throughout Kent and Sussex County, so if you're looking for your dream home, you'll be able to find it throughout those two areas. And our final stop is now in downtown Lewis. I'm here with James Riddle. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing really well. So this is, I mean, right at the top of 2nd Street. You turn onto 2nd Street and bam,
right
there you are. So tell me about this office space a little bit. It's really unique.
Yeah, so the office is available by appointment only in the fall and winter, but it is the home for our luxury division. It's in the Walsh Building, built mm-hmm. by William Walsh back in 1930. We share it with the Lewis Oyster House, just mm-hmm. right next door, which is a local favorite.
Yeah, I mean, it's I think sort of being tied to something, or at least right next door to a local favorite. I mean, I know the Parker Group is so invested in the community and giving back to the community. And I mean, yes. I know you just started with the group. How are you liking it so far?
I'm loving it. And the Get Local initiative, which is a big piece of what you're talking about, is a big piece. And basically, that started with Dustin and Rachel just interviewing a bunch of local businesses, restaurants specifically, mm-hmm. and getting them out there to the demographic that the Parker Group works with.
I know you guys are always out and about in the community. You're going to be out at Apple Scrapple Festival, which is coming up this weekend, and you guys have a lot going on there, right?
Yeah, we do. We are actually raffling off a new Blackstone grill,
hey.
As well as raffling off five, or not raffling, but we are giving away five agent scholarships. To new agents. So if you or you know someone who is looking to get into the real estate industry, come stop by, see us, enter the raffle, and we'd be happy to talk all things real estate with you.
Awesome. And I mean, they really are a great group. I mean, again, like we said, you just started and you're already having a great time.
Yes.
So if you're interested, definitely check it out. But don't go too far. We do have more Coast Life coming your way, so stay right there.
This segment of Coast Life was brought to you by the Parker Group.
Discover a premier commercial development opportunity alongside bustling Route 404 in Sussex County, Delaware. Visibility meets versatility on this sprawling 30-acre property, commanding over 1,200 feet of prime highway frontage in addition to a sweeping expanse of cleared land. This site is a beacon for potential. The existing commercial building with ample parking lot and multiple highway entrances are ideal for any business. Please note that this is a real estate sale only. The existing business does not convey. Bring your dreams and seize this unparalleled opportunity to craft a legacy that stands the test of time.
It's time for the men's 100-meter final, and all eyes are on American Noah Lyles.
And Noah would be wearing legendary designer Pierre Cadeau.
Wow, Emily, is it safe to run in this?
Maybe not for the other runners, but, you know.
Race up, Noah Lyles! Can anyone catch it? It's Noah Lyles right at the line!
Need to go bigger.
I can do bigger.
Bigger.
It's time for the Preston Ford Commercial President's Day sales event. Boost your productivity with an upgraded fleet of vehicles from Preston Ford Commercial. This month, get 1.9% APR financing for 72 months on America's best-selling truck, the 2023 Ford F-150. We offer reliable and flexible service solutions to keep your fleet running. A mobile service van can save you both time and money for your business. View the complete inventory online at PrestonCommercial.com. Remember, cars and trucks cost less in Preston.
Vision loss can be gradual, and your elderly loved ones might not realize how compromised their vision has become. There are some simple ways you can help. Clear all pathways in their home to prevent accidents. Label items with bright colors and make sure those items stay in a designated place. When you need help, consult with a professional in-home care provider. Homo Care Services can set up a safety plan, assist with running errands and other tasks that might be difficult for them.
To learn more about Homewell Care Services, visit DelmarvaExperts.com.
It's always a beautiful day for learning at Shell.
With our summer program that keeps your child physically and mentally active when they're out of school. Through captivating activities and insightful guest speakers, they will expand their knowledge in a fun and interactive way, including educational, hands-on field trips that'll keep your child entertained. Make every summer day memorable with Shell's Early Learning Center. Register now and secure your spot in Shell's summer program before the spots are gone. Shell's, preparing our future generation.
I am proud to lead our personal injury and nursing home neglect practices, but that's not all we do. Call my partners Heidi Gilmore and Michelle Wenz for your real estate needs. For your land use and government issues, call Glenn Mendalis and John Pardee, and Kevin Baird and Barbara Danberg for estate plans. We also litigate medical malpractice cases, construction disputes, contract cases, and class actions. Check out our practice areas on our website, Bear Mendalis, Brockstead, Federico. Right lawyers, right now.
When it comes to building your new home, don't settle for anything less than the best. Bay to Beach Builders is your trusted source for experience, quality, and design. Our team of experts work with you from start to finish to create your dream home. Expect an elevated customer experience with home visualizers, virtual home tours, and technology-inspired selections in our design studios. Visit one of our two convenient locations in Greenwood and Ocean View, or visit baytobeachbuilders.com. Your new home journey is a click away.
So lately we've been talking to you guys about new year, new you, and things that you can just kind of update in your life.
That's right, yeah, we're trying to get you excited, hyped for 2024.
Exactly, but an important part of that is, have you been focusing on your mental health lately?
Not yet.
I know, a bit of a deep question, an important one, but it's so important. That's why we are so excited to share with you today the insight from our new friend, Dr. Wendy Shrivar, a clinical psychologist with BB Healthcare. Thank you so much for being here today, Wendy.
Thank you for having me, I'm so excited.
Of course.
We're so excited too.
We've already been having so much fun. You are so fun to talk to. Before we get into that new year, new you, and all of the talk we're gonna do with mental health, can you just tell us first, what is a clinical psychologist? What do you do?
Wonderful, thank you for asking. A clinical psychologist is a psychologist studies behavior, and we try to understand the effects of behavior on a person. And what we look at is the domains of all areas of functioning. So we're looking at physical functioning, we're looking at emotions, we're looking at cognitive functioning, all the different components that make you you. And so we're incorporating both the physical health with the mental health.
Love that. Right. It's so important. I think there's been a big focus recently on mental health, and I think there's room for growth though still, you know? So what's coming up new with BB that you're a part of?
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. BB has hired me as their first clinical psychologist ever in the history of BB, which is an exciting adventure that BB is embarking on, acknowledging the need for services in Sussex County and really putting themselves out there as a pioneer in integrating behavioral health into the medical facility model. We already have behavioral health within BB, but also taking it further into psychological assessments, psychological functioning. And I use that not only in direct treatment with clients and patients, but also through the family medicine residency program that I'm on faculty with. And I'm able to present information about behavioral health to the residents, guide them, preset them, train them on areas of behavioral health as well.
That's awesome.
Yes, definitely.
Yes, and we talked about, you know, new year, 2024. What are some steps that people can take for a healthier 2024, whether it's mental health steps or physical health steps?
Wonderful. So we all talk about resolutions,
yes,
right? Well, so resolutions are kind of tricky, but they're right in my domain of behavioral functioning. And what I want to encourage your listeners to do is to think about the word resolution. It means resolve, right? What does it mean? That means a solution. So really what we're doing when we're placing New Year's resolutions, we're trying to solve a problem, right? And we typically look at it as weight loss, or I'm gonna stop drinking, or I'm gonna stop eating, or I'm gonna be more active, things like that. Well, I wanna encourage your viewers to think of it in smaller steps. So what we know in the psychological sciences is that behavior change occurs successfully if we want it to be long-lasting in small behavior changes. And so what I encourage people to do is actually to resolve every day, to wake up and say, am I going to approach my day with more resolve to see wonder? Am I going to approach this day with more focus on my physical health, maybe not grab for that extra cookie? So we're not looking in real black and white terms, which tends to lead to less success because we end up not being able to sustain it. And we're looking at behavioral change over the long term.
Interesting. Have you heard of these trends like the hard 75, the hard 30, there's the soft 75? It's basically you start right off the bat and it's like exercise twice a day, one is outside. Do you think those are too much too soon?
I just think it's hard to sustain, right? Because we all have demands in our lives. And so then what happens? Well, what happens a lot of times when people try to get into those programs, they're great programs, right? And it's a great way to encourage motivation, increase, you know, that focus and everything. And that's what the new year's about, right? Fresh new things, new focus. I say take the new year every day. I say take it on your birthday or whenever it works for you to start something new, take it and grab it. But then on the inverse, don't put yourself down if you aren't able to maintain it at the level a program might suggest. Mm-hmm. You can start anew every day, and you can say to yourself, oh, I wasn't able to do that yesterday, but I'm going to do it today, instead of looking in that like polarity of all or nothing.
Yeah, I like that, having a little room in between. And I think we live in such a binary system of this or that, black or white, and we forget about gray spaces, and and we forget about it makes it very difficult to maintain those goals. So I think I'm going to start tomorrow by not hitting snooze three times.
There you go. I can't promise I won't do that, but maybe I'll wake up.
I'm going to try.
I'll wake up and I'll think Leah's doing great right now. That's what I'll do. Well, thank you so much, Wendy. If someone maybe wants to benefit from your services, or they're more interested in learning more, what can they do with BB to work with you?
They can call the clinic that I'm at for clinical services. Is at the Long Neck Primary Care Clinic.
Correct.
And that's where the family medicine program is housed as well. So you might be able to, you know, have primary care there, but that's where my clinic services will be.
Awesome. Fantastic. And we were joking that we're like, can you just stay here all day and evaluate us and our problems? But we don't have time for that. Maybe next time, Wendy, thank you for being here. We'd love to have you back sometime.
Yes, I'd love to come.
Of course, definitely. Anytime, you're always welcome. We have more for you, though, coming up. A lot more fun to get to, so stay right where you are.
This segment of Coast Life was brought to you by BB Healthcare.
When you visit the Delmarva Design Center, you'll experience a selection of appliances, cabinetry, countertops, tile, and flooring all together in one showroom. The 10,000 square foot location has a variety of inspiring samples for any project size or budget. Your dedicated product experts and designers collaborate to bring your dream project to life. Come and see what the kitchen industry buzz is all about. Experience the Delmarva Design Center in Selbyville, Delaware, serving all of Delmarva's coast.
It's time to experience an extraordinary lineup of entertainment at the Ocean City Performing Arts Center. Enjoy performances by the Four Phantoms in concert on February 4th, Wheel of Fortune Live on February 29th, The Simon and Garfunkel Story March 18th, and The Price is Right Live on April 1st. The excitement is building, and now it's your turn to be a part of it. Secure your seats at ococean.com/pack and join us for the most amazing season yet. Don't miss out. Come experience the magic of live performances all in one place at the Ocean City Performing Arts Center. See you there.
It may be freezing outside, but it's warm and toasty at Kids Catch & Lewis. Warm up with friends and family and spark your imagination with adventure, wonder, and fun. Our fully stocked shelves await your arrival with hand-picked toys, games, books, crafts, puzzles, science kits, dress-ups, and unique clothing in newborn to size 8 too. Plus birthdays, baby gifts, and much more. Shop local at Kids Catch & Lewis and at Tidepool Toys and Games in Bethany, Fenwick, and now Rehoboth.
I had major ankle surgery and was wheelchair bound for 4 months. My doctor recommended Peninsula Home Care for physical and occupational therapy in my home, and I'm glad they did. I'm doing what I love, staying active with my children and grandchild, and working at the MAC Center. I am so very thankful for Peninsula Home Care.
Going above and beyond in Maryland and Delaware. Call Peninsula Home Care today.
Good night, girls.
Good night, guys.
Come on, let's go.
Are you ready to sew some carpet?
An LVP.
Okay, I'm ready.
What about our clothes?
Let's do it.
We have tons of carpet that's really nice.
We have cash and carry LVP.
As low as $1.99.
I'll take both.
Maybe you girls are ready.
Wait, was that a dream?
Matt the Carpet Guy, a flooring of your dreams done right.
Not sure what to get your Valentine this year? How about a new walk-in shower from Baths by Spicer Brothers? Right now, through February 14th, save 14% off your entire project and take advantage of no interest and no payments for 18 months. Plus, receive a set of 2 luxury bathrobes. And your new shower can be installed in as little as 1 day with factory-certified 5-star installation guaranteed. Don't miss out. This offer ends February 14th. Baths by Spicer Brothers, because you deserve the best.
Check out this cool little guy. This is Benny and Manlia. He is ready for Sunday.
Yeah, he's so ready, and he's so cool looking in with those shades.
Gosh, the fireplace in the background, the football under the arm. I would not be surprised if Benny shows up on Sunday and makes a touchdown.
Yeah, no, he's got my ultimate big game look.
Yes. I can't tell who he's rooting for, though. Maybe it's just kind of his team didn't make it, so he's going to just support the game.
Maybe he'll be rooting for Taylor Swift.
Like many.
Yes, like many. That's right.
Well, yesterday we showed you guys what we're calling our Game Day Grub. That's right. And yesterday was something sweet. I'm so excited. Leah made today's. It's something a little more savory. And I'm telling you, I'm getting so hungry. It's been torture during the commercial having this sit in front of me.
Yes. So this is a recipe. I'm going to go all recipe blog on you. You know, like, and years ago, my grandmother.
I love
so
this.
What I decided to bring today is an appetizer called pão de queijo. It is a Brazilian cheesy bread, basically.
Amazing.
Pão means bread, queijo means cheese. And I thought this would be an extra fun recipe to bring today because as a spiteful Eagles fan, you can also bring this to your big game party, your football parties,
yes,
and still bring a little piece of the Eagles there since they're gonna be playing in Brazil next season.
And you rang your Eagles green.
That's right.
What a fantastic story. And thanks for sharing these. You and your sister-in-law, thanks for sharing this delicious treat with us. I can't wait to try it. But first, just tell us how it's made.
Yeah, so it's actually pretty simple. The hardest thing to come across is this flour. So tapioca flour is the secret ingredient, and that's probably going to be the hardest thing to find. Not every grocery store has it.
Okay.
But you might even be able to check like some of the Hispanic markets. They might have a better chance of carrying tapioca flour, or the Safeway in Rehoboth had it.
Oh, perfect. Okay,
so,
great.
It's really easy. All you need is one egg that you would just crack in a bowl. It's 2/3 a cup of milk.
Okay.
You pour that in the bowl. It's 1/4 cup of olive oil. Guess what? Pour that in the bowl. And it's, for the flour, it's 1.5 cups of the tapioca flour.
Perfect.
And guess what? Pour it in the bowl.
Perfect.
And then the last ingredient is just 1/2 cup of whatever cheese you want. Traditionally, it's a cheddar cheese.
It
could be a sharp cheddar. I made 2 different kinds here, so I've got a cheddar cheese, and I've got one that I made with mozzarella, because originally that's what I had on hand. But then I was like, no, I'm going to go back out and get the traditional kind.
We would have enjoyed any of this, but these look so good. Also, shout out to the pot, because your pot is so cute that you put these in, but look at that.
So yeah, you mix all the ingredients together. We don't have an oven here on our COASTLIFE set, unfortunately, so I brought in my finished product. So you mix everything in a bowl. You can either blend it or whisk it, honestly. And you cook it at 400 degrees for 20 minutes. I would check on it at about 15. And this is kind of what they should look like when they're done.
Can we please dig in now?
We can absolutely dig in now,
staring me in the face. I actually want to try the mozzarella one.
Go for it.
Okay, perfect. Cheers.
Cheers.
Boom.
As always.
Mmm, they're warm. Yeah, Leah.
So
oh my God.
The tapioca flour gives it that really chewy consistency.
I love this.
And so they're super easy, super portable. You can just pop them back in the oven to reheat them. These we just popped in the microwave to reheat them. And I think they'll be a big crowd pleaser for the
game. I
forgot
you put these in the microwave because as soon as I bit into it, I'm like, oh, it's warm and soft.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I made these last night, so they hold up.
So simple. Oh my gosh, I'm shook. And you kind of told us too, like if you want to add different types of cheeses, you can, right? A little bit. Make it your own?
Yeah, amazing. Make it your own, play around with it, have some fun with it. But yeah, you could kind of, you can really impress your guests with an international recipe. You could be like, that's right, I'm cultured.
I'm so impressed, Leah. You did a great job with
this. Thank
you, it's so good. Yeah. I'm going to your big game party.
Yeah, thanks. Well, we know we got a lot of snacks for you today. We're taking a trip down memory lane on the way with our cottage cheese recipes that we showed to you back in the warmer months.
That's right.
You are truly amazing.
Of course, that's why he is on my dream team.
Are you ready?
That was fantastic!
I'm so jealous!
Even though you haven't got the best mentor, at least look, we're here.
Let's see what your mentoring has done.
I actually got quite emotional.
Can you just shut up?
AGT Fantasy League, Monday on NBC and Peacock.
I have patients that honestly have become friends, and I see like how resilient they were and how well they pulled through and tried every day. I'm privileged to be a part of their care. I'm kind of celebrating there with them.
I've come across a lot of amazing people. Kathy, I tell you, she's the best. She's a sweetheart. Those efforts helped me so much, and I truly appreciate her for it. Most of it, she got me through.
Sometimes life can be a bit out of focus. So at Wink Vision Center, we have next day eye exams available so you can see clearly as soon as possible. Shop our vast selection of designer frames from Vera Wang, Tiffany, Maui Jim, and Under Armour. Already have a prescription? Bring it to us. Wink puts life in better focus, from improving vision to designer frames and quality customer service.
The choice is clear: Wink Vision, Ocean City, and Cambridge.
While becoming the leading deck builder on the shore, we continue to make the process easier.
Paul Davis walks you through the entire process, from design to permitting and building.
Call Paul Davis and get it done this winter, while annual material costs are lower and without the wait. Our AZAC decks are scratch, fade, insect resistant, and look like wood with a lifetime warranty.
Right now, Paul Davis is offering free installation with no money down, no payments, no interest for 12 months. Call today for a free estimate.
Or visit our new showroom in Salisbury.
Enjoy an evening of elegance and unmask a child's future at the 10th Annual Boys and Girls Club Masquerade Ball. Dress up and bring your finest mask to the Lighthouse Cove Event Center in Dewey Beach on Saturday, February 24th. Doors open at 6 for live and silent auctions, an open bar, dinner, and dancing. Save the date and help fund scholarships and key initiatives that benefit kids in our community. For more information, call 302-841-9639.
I potentially be dead is the reality of it. I mean, fentanyl kills a lot of people. I heard about Addiction Medical Facility from another company, and I came in here, you know, no judgment, no stigma. It was, you need help, let's help you. What do you need? They have intensive outpatient. It's a little more intense. You can see your counselor a little more. They've shown nothing but love. Now here I am. I started a grooming business. If I didn't start recovery, it could have looked very different for me. And you just have to remember there's always hope, and I feel like Addiction Medical Facility is the place for that.
You're watching COASTLIFE, and take a look at this. We are back with a really cool setup.
Yes.
We're talking cottage cheese
this
today.
One's for you.
This is. So I have my hair back a little because we're going to be doing some, not cooking, but assembling.
Yes.
Today. All right, so we're talking cottage cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Before you're like, ew, black, change the channel. Stop. Give me a chance. Because cottage cheese, Aaliyah, is trending.
It is trending, and I was a little, and I can vouch for her on this one, because when you were talking about cottage cheese, I know you're a big cottage cheese fan, you were like, I love it with my pineapple in the morning, mm-hmm. And I was like,
I know.
I'm not a fan, but I gave it an honest try, and you know what? I think you swayed me a little,
I
can get on board with the cottage cheese train.
It's not too bad, so we're diving into cottage cheese today. I'm going to show you kind of a sweet breakfast way to enjoy it and a savory one later on. First thing, though, you got to pick out your cottage cheese.
True.
So today, I have large curd and small curd. I know, the word curd is disgusting. But basically what that means is just like, you know, cheese curds. So this has larger chunks of cottage cheese. This one has smaller ones. I tend to go for the lower fat as well, just because, I don't know, just texture wise, but.
Well, and that's kind of part of the reason why cottage cheese is trending in the first place, is that especially for people maybe trying to maintain or lose weight, it's a really healthy option for that, because it can be high in protein and low in fat and carbs and everything else.
That's exactly right. So, Aaliyah, you know this. I'm not a cheese person in general.
No, you're not.
But cottage cheese is my thing. So let's go give this a try. I'm going to show you a really good cottage cheese recipe. First, we're going to pick a fruit of choice. I chose pineapple.
That's your fave.
This is my fave, but you can use, I've seen people do blueberries, strawberries, peaches.
Mm-hmm. I think I did the mango once. That was a good one.
Delish. And sometimes I even do just like the canned pineapple.
Mm-hmm.
But today we're going to keep it fresh. So we're going to cut this really quick. Stay right there. If we're talking canned stuff, if you don't want to cut a fresh fruit, or maybe you just don't have it,
sure.
Is sometimes I like the crushed pineapple, because then when you mix it in with the cottage cheese, it's kind of like ice cream.
Okay, and see, I didn't even consider crushed pineapple.
Yeah, really good. I don't crush it myself, but.
Well, right. I mean, we are time savers, if nothing else.
But yeah, that is really good because it's like ice cream and it just always has a bit of pineapple in the cottage cheese. I also think it helps with the texture.
Yeah.
If you're a texture person, cottage cheese can be difficult to eat.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to cut up this pineapple in bite-sized pieces, and we're going to throw it in a bowl. And off
to the races.
Yeah, honestly. So we have a little bowl here. I'll just throw some in. All right, of course, this or that, whatever you want. I like a little bit bigger chunks, as you can see, but just whatever size pineapple you want to make. Then you have to choose your curd size.
Okay.
Okay, so I think for this, what I normally do for the breakfast dish, for the sweet dish, is small curd.
Okay.
Again, it just helps with that texture.
Mm-hmm.
And no measurements here, Aaliyah. We're just going to dive right in.
That's how I like, that's what I like to see.
And we're just going to put a bunch on. I will warn you guys, if you're doing fruit, like a juicy fruit, like pineapple, sometimes the juice will kind of water down. Mm-hmm. So if I ever like meal prep this, I won't stick the fruit in until the morning of.
Yeah.
Because it's just kind of unsettling seeing your cottage cheese all watery. You know what I mean?
So. See, now I'm learning, because I feel like when I tried, you know, to do the cottage cheese on my own, because you told me, you know, fruit and cheese, and I was like, okay, great. And I thought I nailed it, but you've got more tips and tricks than I was thinking, because I was trying to meal prep it, and I had, you're right, the juices from the fruit, and so like, by day three, if you're trying to meal prep, like that third jar of fruit and cottage cheese, you're a little like, ooh, I don't know.
Yeah, and it might taste good, but doesn't
look. I still ate it, yeah, it tasted fine.
Yeah, but it doesn't look all that appetizing. So my go-tos again for toppings, we have the pineapple, we have the cottage cheese, cinnamon, and if you're feeling crazy, honey. That is it. I've also seen people do granola.
Ooh.
Pumpkin seeds could be really good.
Yes, you can really get creative with cottage cheese. Who knew?
Exactly. So hopefully you like it, Leah. There's a fork right there if you want to grab some.
Thank you.
And I'll grab this one. Oh, there's an extra. Thank you. Perfect. All right, make sure you try to get a little bit of each. We got the pineapple, the honey, and the cinnamon. Oh. Gonna be a little messy.
And I actually think the way that I did this wrong the first time was I started with the cottage cheese and topped with the fruit, but I actually think I really like starting with the fruit and topping with the cottage cheese because that texture is a little weird, so you can kind of better judge how much cheese you actually want.
That's exactly it, the ratio. All right, let's try it out.
Right.
What do you think?
I'm into it.
Yeah?
I think you've taught, I think this is gonna be my new starter breakfast.
It's not bad, and again, it's healthy. So for someone who wants to be healthy, but hates being healthy, I mean, really, it is good, so.
I like that it's also really, like, it feels very light when you're eating it, and I don't like to really be weighed down by breakfast first thing in the morning.
Right.
So that is a very, like, just light, fresh way to start your day.
Exactly. So I've been eating this since high school. Honestly, 90% of the week I start my day with this, but coming up, I'm gonna show you a savory way to enjoy cottage cheese. So we'll try that in just a minute. Be right back.
Have you seen those crazy HVAC deals? Don't fall for that. At Above and Beyond Service Heating and Cooling, we just don't make promises, we deliver results. With our Peace of Mind maintenance agreement, you can rest assured we will keep up with your system throughout the year. You're not just a customer, you're our neighbor. Take advantage of our 0% finance for up to 72 months or up to $3,000 in rebates on a new train system. Call Above and Beyond Services to keep your family comfortable. Remember, it's hard to stop a train.
Look who's cooking for Sussex County Habitat for Humanity. Volunteer chefs from local realtors compete for the best appetizers, entrees, and desserts, and you can try them all. It's an evening of tasty treats, raffles, and door prizes at the St. Jude Parish Center on March 21st at 6 p.m. in Lewis. For more information about the event and to get your tickets, go to SussexCountyHabitat.org. We'll see you, Delmarva, at the Look Who's Cooking Challenge, March 21st in Lewis.
Every visit is an adventure at Browse About Books in Rehoboth Beach. Search our hand-picked book collection and find something in every genre. From bestsellers to some of our staff picks, you'll uncover a new adventure every time. After you've browsed our extensive book selection, explore our gift shop, where you'll find an exciting array of toys, gifts, Rehoboth-themed items, and home decor. Browse About Books on Rehoboth Avenue, a fun, friendly place to shop for books and so much more.
Allergies aren't fun for anyone, especially when they work their way into your home. A professional air duct cleaning from Stanley Steamer can dramatically improve indoor air quality and significantly reduce indoor allergens. Installing our whole home purification system Restore will even help prevent the spread of airborne viruses and bacteria. If you want to significantly reduce allergy triggers in your home, call or go online to book a free inspection today.
Persino Wells & Woodland specializes in estate planning and elder law. It's the only thing we do. We help Delaware families create estate plans that work because to us, a true estate plan is much more than documents. I'm Michelle Persino Wells.
And I'm Amber Woodland. Estate planning helps families protect their assets from the cost of long-term care, provide for their loved ones, and simplify the tasks to be completed after their deaths. We help families plan today to protect their families tomorrow.
You're watching Coast Life, so it is, of course, football season.
Yeah.
So, chips and dip.
A lot of snacks being had during football season.
Right, so we're going to show you kind of a healthier but also still delicious way to enjoy a chips and dip of sorts.
Yeah, and I like the idea of healthier alternatives at football snacks because, like, they are very heavy and, like, football, but after, like, every Sunday, you're like, I don't know how many more of these chips and dips I can eat.
That's exactly it. Let's move on to the savory. We have a bowl here. This is super easy, and there's lots of ways to do it. The first very easy step is we're just going to dump some cottage cheese right into the dip bowl.
I think we can handle that.
I think we can. So for this dip, we're using the large curd.
Okay.
That's for a couple reasons. So you now have options. I'm not meaning to confuse you, but now that you put the cottage cheese into the bowl, a couple things you can do.
Yeah.
One, get a hand mixer, hand mix the cottage cheese. It's gonna make it fluffy, kind of make it creamy, smooth it out. Or, like we did, we're using the large curd because we're just gonna kind of mush it up a little bit.
Yep.
Because we kind of want this dip for Leah and I to be a little chunkier.
Yeah, just a little.
Yeah, we just decided that'd be kind of good for today. So whatever you want, even a food processor.
Yeah, or a blender, if that's all you have on hand.
Right, just get it however consistency you want, but if you want it a little smoother, you can. So if, when I said savory grossed you out, you can kind of just stop here, put some like honey in, and dip apples in it.
Yeah, you could stay in the sweet family.
That's pretty good, but I did promise savory, so I brought a couple of my favorite seasonings, but you go crazy, okay? I'm a big salt bae.
All right.
So we're going to salt the cottage cheese. I like a lot of salt, Leah. I hope
I see that.
Okay. I should have asked my partner here.
No, I'm ready.
Okay, you like Old Bay?
Yes, I do.
Who doesn't? So we're going to sprinkle some Old Bay in.
Delmarva Coast, baby.
Exactly, hey. So we'll go a little crazy with the Old Bay. And then, let's go a little crazy.
You're crazy.
Yeah. I said crazy. Yeah. Let's go crazy.
Yeah. Right.
There we go. All right, Leah. Now, I'm going to be honest. I have not made this exact concoction before.
So we're being a little bold here,
We are. I took what I've used before, because again, I normally keep it sweet. Mm-hmm. I talked to some people in the office, took the savory, so we're gonna really mix this in.
And you can always play around with flavors that you like too. I mean, you had mentioned dill sort of as well would be maybe good either in this or just as its own. Like a dill dip is always
totally
good.
Totally. Salt, garlic, and like dill dip in this would be delish. Yeah. I just felt like, you know, Delmarva Coast, we had to add some Old Bay.
Yeah, yeah.
So like Leah said, don't take this and just run with it and like bring it to your family cookout.
Play around
and
first.
And be like, the page said. Yeah, be a little careful. All right, we have these grilled crostinis. Is that how you say them? All right, Leah, you do the honors?
All right, here we go.
Okay.
These are cute. Yeah, they got little grill lines.
Yeah, I guess you could use like potato chips too, but.
Yeah, whatever you wanted, I guess.
All right, I'm just going in with dip.
I think you're going to do a little. I'm going to, do a little.
Okay, brace your ears because these are crunchy.
Yes.
We're going to be crunching in our mics. Leah.
Okay.
I'm actually so surprised.
Like we said, we didn't really do an experimental taste before we jumped in with this.
No, but this is good.
But it does remind you sort of a seafood dip without the seafood. So maybe if you even have a shellfish allergy, this is a good way to enjoy.
I'm really happy with this. And I like that we kept it a little chunky.
Yeah,
because it kind of just reminds me of like a crab dip or something without the crab. All right. There you have it. So maybe you can bring this to your next cookout or your football party, and no one's even going to know it's cottage cheese.
Yep.
Well, thank you for joining us on our Cottage Cheese Chronicles. I hope you tried this out, and let us know if you do and if you like it, especially if you're looking for a healthier way to enjoy football season.
Yeah, snacking during football season.
All right, thanks for joining us. Hey, more Coast Life still ahead, though, so stay right where you are.
It's time for the men's 100-meter final, and all eyes are on American Noah Lyles.
And Noah would be wearing legendary designer Pierre Cadeau.
Wow. Emily, is it safe to run in this?
Maybe not for the other runners, but, you know.
Right side, Noah Lyles. Can anyone catch it? It's Noah Lyles right at the line.
Woo! Viva Olympics! So we need to go bigger.
I can do bigger.
Bigger.
Is your dryer venting into your crawl space?
Do you even know?
Each year, nearly 3,000 house fires are caused by dryers, meaning to do with improper maintenance and venting.
Vents should be cleaned and inspected annually and should never vent into the crawl space.
Call DryTech. We'll clean and inspect your dryer vent and, if necessary, reroute it and assess your crawl space for mold and moisture damage. Call now for our dryer vent cleaning and checkup for just $149. Plus, get our crawl space assessment free. DryTech, Delmarva's original crawl space expert.
Hey, are you the bath guy? Are you licensed and insured?
I believe you're looking for us.
At Peninsula Bath, we're your local pros for bathroom remodeling, and that's it. Top quality, customer focus, and competitively priced. Ask about our free shower door upgrade and our neediest bathroom contest.
Thank you, Peninsula Bath.
This particular house, the Parker Group found it for us, and it just fit perfectly. They always had solutions. You'd call with a problem and they'd address it immediately.
They're accessible. I mean, I think that's probably about the best way to put it. They're constantly getting back to us and letting us know we have it, we're working on it, and we'll get back to you.
So between emails and DocuSigns, we were able to do everything remotely, and we could have even closed remotely. So they really showed us exactly what we were looking for.
Spill the Tea is sponsored by the Spice and Tea Exchange of Rehoboth.
Well, just in time for Valentine's Day, we are fixing your relationship drama today, or we're going to try to, on our Spill the Tea segment with our friends, of course, at the Spice and Tea Exchange.
That's right. They're right there on Rehoboth Avenue in Rehoboth Beach. If you've got a tea lover, maybe that would be the perfect little set that you could do for Valentine's Day.
That's a great idea. Okay, yeah. Well, maybe you can relate to this story, Leah. I'll get us updated while you spill some tea. What kind are we drinking?
We are drinking because, again, when you get through the winter, you just want something a little sunny and warm. So we're drinking Florida Sunshine.
Nice.
It's a white tea.
Perfect.
Sunshine in a cup with uplifting floral and citrus flavors. This refreshing tea blend is perfect for hot or iced tea. Any time of day.
Amazing. We're drinking it hot today.
Yes, we
okay.
are.
All right, you guys. So here's the deal. This is what's going on. This young lady wrote in. I shouldn't say young lady. She's in her late 20s. But
Rude.
That's still young. Forget what I said. Anyways, this young lady who's my age writes in that she's married to her husband. They're the same age. Mm-hmm. They don't have any kids. She has a job that pays a lot more than his.
Yeah.
They both work full time, but she's the breadwinner. Fine. Everything's dandy. Because they don't have kids and they don't really have a lot of other responsibilities besides their current home, she wants to really save a lot of money. She wants to dive in deep this year and save a lot of money. So she's been asking her husband, who already works full-time, like I said, to pick up overtime because he can at his job.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where she was very fair in her reasoning. And so her reason she wants him to work more full-time is put money towards the savings. She kind of wants him to make closer to the more amount of money she works because she feels like maybe she's putting more money aside. He says he's okay with it. He's worked a few overtime shifts, but he's like, our schedules line up already, so not so well. I want to see you more often. So his thing is like, we already make fine money. I want to have more quality time. She's thinking he's maybe a little lazy. That's fine. Right now they are sharing finances, so they have a similar bank account. She said it's pushing her to want separate accounts and separate finances so they can buy a bigger house, blah, blah, blah. What do we think? I know. This is hard.
It is hard. And I mean, finances are always one of the biggest struggles in relationships because I think it's very rare that two people approach finances the same exact way and the same exact thought process.
Yeah.
And, you know, personally, I think I sound a little bit more like the husband here where quality time is really important. And I think that just if you don't want to, like, that time goes by so fast.
Yeah.
And I also feel like, okay, just because you don't have kids doesn't mean you don't want to spend that time together. And I think there is this pressure on people who don't have kids or don't necessarily want to have kids that their time is less valuable and therefore they could just be making money, like always make money. If you're not having kids, what are you doing if you're also not making money?
Right.
And there needs to be room to love and enjoy life even while you're striving for financial goals. So I think personally, I sound a little bit more like the husband, so I want to side with him. But I don't think the wife is wrong. Like, if that's a goal they're setting together, then I don't know if it sounds like it's a goal that they set together. It kind of sounds like it's one that she set and has always had in mind, and so she's going for it. And he's kind of getting left behind. But I don't know. I don't really know where I stand on this one.
It's tough. Like you said, I get it. I also, something really big for me is that my partner is a very hard worker. I do appreciate a man who works very hard and provides, and so I get why she wants that. But I think it would be different if he worked part-time but was able to work full-time. Maybe her wanting him to go to work full-time, I'd understand that more.
Right, but he's working full-time.
He's already working full-time. It's not his fault he doesn't make as much money as you. We don't know what their jobs are. And I'm with you on this. I think it's easy to, when you're younger and you have all these goals of, okay, we want kids, we want the bigger house, I want a nice retirement, we have to save, your life is gonna go by. And I think it's sweet that he's like, it's not like he's lazy, he's not going to work.
No, he's going to work, he's working full time.
He's working some overtime.
He just wants to also spend that, and I mean, I work at an opposite schedule from my boyfriend, and so like in the summertime, we almost never see each other because he's working all weekends and evenings and I'm like barely home. And so we just like, we never see each other for 3-4 months out of the year and it stinks.
It definitely stinks. I think the biggest red flag in this whole story is that she wants to separate their finances. I'm not afraid of separate finances. Do what works for you. My issue is you started joint. Now what's going to happen when you have separate? You have a lot more money than him because you make more money than him. So when it's time to put the down payment on the house, are you going to be salty that you're putting the down payment down?
Yeah, or maybe just, you know, have a joint finances and also have separate finances.
Yes.
One that you're both contributing to, and then have your independent finances that you can spend how you would.
Exactly. Yeah, I think this is a... Honestly, this is one of those things where it's I would support like some type of marriage counseling.
Yeah.
Because it's not that you're going towards divorce, but it might be nice to have a third party find a compromise for
you. Yeah, or a financial expert that could maybe help both parties reach an understanding about finances.
Or maybe drink some tea together and just relax.
Just relax.
Enjoy life. That's, we're just kidding. That's way easier said than done, but this Florida Sunshine tea is really good.
Delicious, yes. You won't have any problems just enjoying the Florida Sunshine tea that you can find at the Spice and Tea Exchange on Rehoboth Avenue in Rehoboth Beach. Yes. We do have a little bit more coastlife to get to, so we will be right back.
Life isn't always easy. Sometimes we need a little bit of help to work through life's more challenging problems. At Addiction Medical Facility, we are here for you, believing in your strengths to overcome any obstacle. Whether it's addiction to substance use disorders or mental health issues, there's hope for a better tomorrow. Together, we can tackle what is holding you back. Our medication-assisted treatment combines FDA-approved medication with counseling, offering a holistic approach tailored to your needs. Addiction Medical Facility. Together, we find hope and healing.
Deal or no deal. Welcome to Deal or No Deal Island. It's a whole new game with a lot more money. Now go get those cases. More adventure. Anyone afraid of heights?
Wait.
More risk. Don't worry, they don't bite that hard. Same question. Deal or no deal?
Deal or No Deal Island, February 26th on NBC and Peacock.
16 years ago, we founded Community Bank Delaware with the goal of providing high-quality banking services to our local community. Here you meet with decision makers, people just like you who live in and love this community. We provide the newest banking technologies to our customers, supported by our local team of banking professionals. Our bank serves clients throughout Sussex County, and we continue to grow, all thanks to you. Community Bank Delaware, where community matters.
Nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Ow.
Delmarva's Classic Rock, Big 107.7.
Yourself and experience Lord's Mercantile in our award-winning garden center. Venture our 5 acres and find a wide variety of plants and much more. For 45 years, our sales team has helped our customers find exactly what they want. While you're here, visit Lord's Mercantile next door. We carry a wide variety of gifts, home decor, treats, and more. From trendy to classic, we have something for everyone. Check us out online and on social media. Shop and sign up for the Lord's Loyalty Program and join our Lord's family today.
Are you having one of those days? Where everything that can go wrong does? Meet Preston, a normal guy with extraordinary bad luck. This is where the law office trap nickel steps in. We've got your back, even when you fall on it. Our skilled personal injury team is committed to defending your rights and converting adversity into significant compensation. Don't hesitate. Get the justice you deserve. The law office of trap nickel. Your priority is our priority.
All right, team. Well, you guys know, of course, a few days ago, we lost one of the greats.
Yeah.
Oh, Toby Keith. And something really sweet, though, is people on Delmarva and pups on Delmarva are honoring his memory. So we just wanted to show you, before we let you go, this really sweet pic. You saw Benny earlier in our show with his football, his big day, game day outfit on. I shouldn't say outfit, uniform.
Yes. Well, he had his sunglasses, too, though, so that's true. A bit of an outfit.
It was a fit. It was a vibe. But check this out. He and his owner also wanted to honor Toby Keith, so he dressed up as Toby.
Cute.
How amazing is that?
I know. There has been a lot of love coming out on social media that you see people sharing their pictures with Toby Keith. And I mean, he did a lot of charity work and just like he did a lot for the community.
He did, definitely. And our troops. I mean, holy cow. That's why I love that Benny has the little American flag theme going on. It's so sweet. And Coast Country.
That's right.
They did a little tribute to Toby as well.
Got to.
Love seeing that. We thought you guys would get a kick out of that. I know we have a lot of country music fans here. And I just envisioned Benny's dressed up as Toby when he's singing Courtesy of the Red, White,
Aww.
One of the best songs ever created. So just now I'm putting my opinion in all this, but we know you guys would like that.
Yes, and I know that we've got great stuff coming up tomorrow. I think tomorrow is National Pizza Day.
Yeah.
A little heads up for you, so just keep that in mind as you go about your day tomorrow, that influences dinner decisions or snack time decisions.
We eat pizza for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. We would never judge you. We also have our final Game Day Grub segment for you. It's going to be really good, so you don't want to miss out tomorrow.
It is for us to get on out of here, though. Pass things along to our friends, Coast TV News at 5. Take it from here. Have a wonderful rest of your evening, and we'll see you tomorrow.